So coming to intercostal chest line incision, which is again a life-saving procedure, needle thoracocentesis, we all know we do it. And then the intercostal chest line, sometimes we do it, sometimes we depend on the cardiothoracic surgeons or the pulmonologists. So the healthy parietal pleura secretes around 100 to 150 ml of pleural fluid per day. The pleural space is usually contains 30 to 50 ml of fluid and is free of air. So excessive fluid or air need to be removed from the pleural space, as they can severely impair your respiratory mechanics. So apical intercostal chest lines are ideal to drain air, while basal ICDs are more effective in draining fluid. So what is the purpose of putting your ICD? Whether you are putting ICD for pneumothorax, then you have to put apical intercostal line to drain air. Or if you are putting ICD for draining more fluid, that is for the pleural effusion, you have to put the basal ICD for the pleural effusion. So what are the indications? The most common indication in the ICU is pleural effusion and pneumothorax. And when you are getting a trauma patient, there is a lot of blood in the pleural space, that is hemothorax, then we go and keep the ICD. And chylothorax, if there is any injury to the lymphatic thoracic duct, and then if there is any chylothorax, then we have to put and then in sometimes the patients with tumors, we put the ICD if there's a chylothorax. If there's a pyothorax, again, you have to drain the pus. Otherwise, whatever antibiotic you give, that is not going to work. And then early empyema also should be drained by using ICD, or we can put a pigtail catheter. So prepare the patient. The position and identification of the site. The patient will be usually in a supine position, with the head end of the bed is elevated to 30 to 40 degrees. The operator is positioned so that the site of insertion is approximately at the level of their elbow or slightly above. The drain is usually inserted through the fourth or fifth intercostal space in the mid axillary line, which corresponds to the safe triangle. The triangle of safety, safe triangle, is very, very important. This is the common question asked in any critical care exam. So the patient positioning is very, very important. And then the access to the safe triangle, that is a triangle of safety. This is a relatively, why this triangle is safe? Because this is relatively amuscular and avascular area. So the bordered anteriorly by lateral margin of the pectoralis major, and posteriorly by anterior margin of the latissimus dorsi, and inferiorly by the origin of serratus anterior. This is the triangle of safety. So what are the equipment you need? You have to keep 28 French chest line, a syringe and hypodermic needles for the local anesthetics, swab on the stick for the skin disinfection, or you can use gauze piece and then chlorhexidine with the forceps, we can clean that area. You need a sterile drape with a hole, and you need a dissecting forceps. You need tubing clamps, and then you need scissors. You need knife for the skin incision, or you need suture for posturing. So after giving the local anesthetic 3 to 5 minutes to act, the procedure progresses as follows. 2.5 to 3 centimeters horizontal incision in the fifth intercostal space in the mid axillary line. Deepen the incision to the subcutaneous fat layer. Insert a purse string on drain holding tie to the skin edge of the incision. The ends of these sutures are clipped and kept away, and 2-0 nylon or ethylene sutures are typically used for the purse string, while a robust material like 1-0 silk is used for the drain holding as a drain holding tie. Using blunt dissection with the dissecting artery forceps, the external intercostal muscle layer is exposed. The fibers are split parallel to their normal orientation. The parietal pleura is reached and can be felt with the index finger. You can feel the parietal pleura. After puncturing the parietal pleura with the tip of artery forceps, the index finger is then passed into the pleural space and swept around to make sure there are no adhesions between the lung and pleura. It is a good practice to seal the wound with index finger at the point of pleural puncture to avoid spillage of fluid onto the patient's bed. So using curved long artery forceps, the tip of chest drain is pushed carefully and gently into the pleural space. Remove the forceps, then the tip of the drain has been advanced 5 cm into the pleural space. Direct the drain either towards the diaphragm or towards the neck of the patient, depending on whether the intention is to drain the fluid or air. The drain should be advanced at least 5 cm for the last side hole to allow adequate buildup of negative pressure when the suction is applied. So you can watch the video on the YouTube. So it is very, very easy. And you can watch the video, and then when you attend a trauma workshop like ATLS workshops, they allow you to do this ICD incision on goats, and they do a very good workshop. So once secured in position with previously inserted drain holding suture, the drain is connected to the drainage system, and suction of -3 or -5 kilopascals enables the effective drainage of the both air and fluids and helps in re-expansion of the collapsed lung. The wound is dressed with sterile dressing. A chest x-ray has to be done shortly after the drain incision to check the position of the drain, ensure acceptable lung re-expansion and drainage of the pleural effusion, exclude possible complication. So coming to another procedure, that is ultrasound-guided drainage of the pleural fluid. So we all know the lung ultrasound. We do lung ultrasound very commonly, and the large simple anechoic effusions note measurement from the skin to the maximum depth of the effusions for drainage purpose, and the complex effusions. So there is no septa here. This is a clear cut effusion, and then the complex effusions with septations and echoic debris is difficult, and then you cannot drain the entire fluid, and sometimes you need thoracoscopy or VADs for these So ultrasound guided drainage pleural fluid. The chest wall is prepared with antiseptic lotion, and surgical drapes are applied like any other procedure. The curvilinear probe is used. So we have different probes. The curvilinear probe on the ultrasound machine is aligned parallel to the ribs, and the maximum depth of the effusion is identified. The skin to the pleural distance is measured by using electronic calipers, and the note is made of the costophrenic angle and the diaphragm to avoid the injury to the liver and spleen. Depending on the size of the effusion, the puncture aspiration can be either performed blindly after the site has been correctly marked, or under the real-time ultrasound guidance, keeping the needle tip continuously monitoring to avoid the visceral injury. So after giving the local anesthetic, once the adequate needle position is confirmed by the fluid aspiration, the outer sheath is advanced from the trocar and the needle is removed. The guide wire is passed through the sheath and coil in the pleural space. After the sheath has been removed, the dilators have passed over the guide wire to make a tract sufficiently big enough for the catheter. The catheter of the choice for the simple effusions is 8 to 10 French multi-site hole pictile. So sometimes we don't go for ICD, we put ultrasound guided pictile. The complex effusions may require larger bore lumens to facilitate adequate drainage. Sometimes debris will come and the small bore lumens will get blocked. The catheter is rail loaded over the guide wire, ensuring all sides of holes are positioned within the pleural space. The guide wire is subsequently removed. Coming to ultrasound guided drainage of the abdominal fluid, and the same technique as pleural fluid, the suitable site is usually right or left iliac fossa of the flank is identified, and then the maximum fluid depth is assessed, making sure there is sufficient clearance from the other structures, and real-time guidance can be used to avoid any injury to the bowel or viscera. So ascites in the right flank, note the measurement from the skin to the maximum depth of collection for the drainage. Using the electronic calipers, you can identify, you can quantitate, and then you can put a needle and remove it. So the continuous needle, continuous ultrasound monitoring will help in to prevent the injury to the bowel and the viscera.